right often.
Every day, Mina, I promise.
I promise to study my shorthand so that I shall be able to do your letters when we're married.
Jonathan!
Jonathan!
Time for you to go.
Yes, of course.
Jonathan, I do wish Bohemia wasn't so far away.
Now, Lucy, you'll only upset your sister.
But you don't know two words of the language.
No, but one can tell from the Count's letters that he has a good command of English.
I know you girls will laugh at your poor old mother, but I've had cook put up a few sandwiches for you, Jonathan. One never knows about food when travelling abroad.
Thank you, Mrs. Westerner. That was very thoughtful of you. Well, it's time to go.
Goodbye, Jonathan.
Excuse me. Do any of you speak English? Speak English?
I speak some little.
Well, when we left the inn, some of the men and women pointed at me. Like this.
Yes.
What does it signify? What does it mean?
They say it is a charm against the evil eye.
Why should I need the charm any more than, say, yourself?
Where are you alighting?
At the head of the Borger Pass.
It is very important that we get there well before midnight and are across the border.
Really? Why is that?
You do not know what day this is. It is the 4th of May, the eve of St. George. When the clock strikes midnight, all the evil things of the world shall take command.
Concede quasi mus omnipotens Deus, o protectiones tuis gratiam corrimus, liberaci amalis omnibus, serviamus securo tibimente serviamus.
Where do you travel? From the border?
I'm a solicitor, and I'm taking some documents concerning a property in England for a Count Dracula to sign.
Mr. Goy.
Terog. Terog not a Dutch. Not go. Not a Dutch.
My dear lady, I have to go. Please, don't upset yourself.
Not a Dutch.
you please the correct time?
It's 6:30.
Marie-Pédie!
Here is Patel Tehuchar, the head of the Borgo.
Thank you.
God go with you.
Pentus in etatia, mame.
For your mother's sake.
Thank you.
There should be a carriage waiting for me. Wait, moment, bitte.
I was told there'd be a carriage waiting for me.
I'm sorry, we cannot delay. We cannot.
But you can't leave me here in the middle of nowhere.
Welcome to my house, Mr. Harker. Come freely, go safely.
Count Dracula?
I am Count Dracula. Will you come in? And please, Leave here some of the happiness you bring.
No, no, allow me.
I insist, you are my guest. It is late, and the servants are not available at this hour. Close the door. Follow me.
Thank you.
Do forgive me if I do not join you. I have already dined. You will please help yourself to whatever you wish.
Thank you.
Some tokai, perhaps?
That would be very welcome. Excuse my asking, but these plates, are they solid gold?
They are 400 years old. We boyards are more aware of what they say to us of our past than of their value or utility.
They are very distinctive. You must know a great deal of the history of Transylvania.
All there is to know, I'm afraid. Sometimes I think too much. Listen to them, the children of the night. What music. Well, Mr. Harker, tell me about this house in England, which has been purchased for me. What is the name of it?
Carfax.
Carfax. What is the origin of the word?
Well, it is an old house in a district of London known as Purfleet, near the River Thames. It's four-sided, and each corner follows a point of the compass.
The name, then, is possibly a corruption of the French quatre faces, four faces.
That's absolutely correct, Count.
And how did Mr. Hawkins come to hear of it?
My fiancée's sister knows a doctor in the area.
You are engaged to be married?
Yes, sir.
And does your fiancée live in London?
Yes, with her family. But they always go away for the summer.
Of course, the English custom, to a spa or watering place.
They go to Whitby on the Yorkshire coast. Well, sir, your house is very near the sanatorium that this doctor runs, a Dr. Seward.
The house is old, I'm glad. A house cannot be made habitable in a day. And after all, how few days go to make up a century? Mr. Hawkins thinks highly of you.
That's very kind of Mr. Hawkins.
And adds, Mr. Harker shall be ready to attend on you during his stay when you will, and to take your instructions in all matters.
I think you will find everything in order.
Thank you. Give it to me. There. It is morning. How inconsiderate of me to keep you talking. You must be tired. But tomorrow, you shall sleep as late as you will. Good night, Mr. Harker.
Good night, sir.
Oh, Mr. Harker.
Sir?
You may go anywhere you wish in the castle. However, the doors of certain rooms are locked. It stands to reason that you will not be able to enter these rooms and should not try. They have been locked for generations, and only the masters of the house have known why. Respect this tradition, please. Thank you. Good morning. Or rather, good evening. If you have slept well, it is already dusk. Stupid things. You shouldn't trust them. The trouble with mirrors is that they don't reflect quite enough, don't you think? You've cut yourself. One of these two girls is your fiancée.
Yes, sir. The one on the right.
And the other one?
Her sister.
An embarrassing choice. They are both very pretty. English literature is the richest in the world. But then, of course, I'm partial. I have a passion for the English language. I would wish to speak it faultlessly, perfectly.
But you almost do, Count.
This almost is disheartening. You shall remain here for a while so that I may learn from you and shatter this almost irrevocably. Please correct the slightest error in my speech. However small, please correct it.
Frankly, sir, I was hoping to return to London as soon as you've signed the lease of the House of Perfleet.
No, no, you must remain here for a month at the very least.
A month? Do you really wish me to stay so long?
Only my needs are to be consulted. Remember the instructions of your employer. Look upon it as a little holiday.
I understand, sir.
You will write to Mr. Hawkins and your fiancé, should you so wish. Or have you already done so?
No, sir, I could find no writing paper in my room.
Oh, there is some writing paper here on the desk. Please sit down. Very, very thin. The thinnest paper possible. One can almost see through it.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, indeed. You will forgive me, but I have many things to attend to before I set sail for England. I must go now. By the way, do not, under any circumstances, sleep in this room. Please.
Very well, sir.
Good. Until tomorrow, then.
Nina. Nina. Am I going mad?
So unlike Jonathan. Everything is going very well. I am very well. Nothing about his journey or what happened, nothing.
Much the same story in mine, my dear. And I must say, I find it very surprising that he needs to stay a month.
A month? Oh, no.
The Count has requested me to remain 1 month. And as it's your wish that I should do everything to accommodate him, I have naturally agreed.
Oh, what are we going to do?
Well, if I hear anything more, I'll certainly let you know.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. Oh, we shall be going to our house in Wickley for the summer at the end of the week.
I'll keep in touch with you, my dear.
Thank you.
I'm going to stop. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 6, 6, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6, 6, 7, 6, 8, 6, 9, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7,
hot chocolate. Well, darling, it was one of the few things that stopped you walking in your sleep.
I haven't done that for a long time.
No. We just got into the habit of drinking hot chocolate.
And you must get into the habit of going to bed earlier, Mummy. You know what Dr. Seward said?
Oh, doctors. All the same, I think I shall turn in. Now, mind you, I feel a great deal better.
Good night, Mummy.
Child. Good night, Nina.
Good night, Mummy.
Good night.
Good night. Are you really worried about Jonathan? Wouldn't you be? Poor Mina. You're so much in love. And you really don't understand men at all.
You do, I suppose.
Well, I've been longing to tell you. I've had two proposals of marriage.
I know about Dr. Seward.
He's called Quincy.
Quincy?
Quincy P. Holmwood. He's a very handsome American boy from Texas. And he's something high up in the embassy in London.
Where did you meet him?
Oh, well, that's the embarrassing bit. John Seward introduced us.
Lucy. Which one are you going to marry?
I'm really not quite sure. Well, why can't a woman marry two men? Or at least as many as want her. Save all this trouble.
Oh, you really are impossible.
Dear John, I think it'll be Quincy. Good night, Mina.
Good night.
And I shouldn't worry about Jonathan. If I know anything about men, he'll be having a lovely time with that count of his. What with deeds and torts and searches, all washed down with local wine.
It's not Jonathan's style at all.
I was only joking. Good night, darling.
Night.
And I promised to study like Shorthand.
Every day. Oh, my dearest, how I hate to go. Just a moment's notice. Every day.
He's young and strong.
When we're married, when we're married.
Oh, my dearest, I hate to go away like this.
I promise to study my shorthand so that I'll be able to do your letters when we're married. Married. When we're married. Married. You'll write often.
Every day, Mina, I promise.
You'll write often. You'll write often. You're right off.
Don't touch him. Don't look at him. Leave him. Back. Back.
You never loved me.
You never loved. You never love.
Oh, yes, I have. Come. I need him for a while. Then you shall have him. He will be yours. All yours.
When we're married.
Just a moment's notice.
Now go. I must awaken him.
And tonight, you can give us nothing?
Nothing?
I expect you are anxious to return to England.
I should like to start back soon, it's true.
Very well. Write a letter to your friends saying that you have already left the castle and have arrived at Bistritz, where you are awaiting the weekly express.
May I ask with what object, sir?
The posts are few and uncertain. Writing now will ease the minds of Mr. Hawkins and your fiancée.
Count Dracula.
Yes?
I've been struck by a curious fact.
Yes?
I've not seen a single servant since I've been here. Yet my meals are served, my bed is made. Tell me, are we alone in the castle?
Alone? How could one be alone in this castle? In its most remote corners, the past, the living past, is present, surrounding us.
That does not answer my question, sir. I've been here for 3 weeks and have not once stepped outside the castle.
I would gladly have shown you the countryside if you had expressed the wish to do so.
When would we have gone? In the dead of night? I've never set eyes on you during the day.
I have a large estate to manage.
Nor have I seen you eat.
I eat alone.
And who would have driven the coach?
My driver.
You are lying, Count Dracula.
You are losing your temper, Mr. Harker.
Who took me back to my room last night?
Back to your room? What do you mean?
I slept by mistake in the library. I witnessed a nightmare and woke up in my bed. How did I get there?
Am I to be held responsible for a vivid imagination?
Now you tell me to write a letter saying that I've already left the castle. Why? You're keeping me here against my will. Why?
To improve my English, Mr. Harker, as you very well know. But if you wish to go, by the time you pack your portmanteau, my driver will be waiting for you to take you wherever you wish.
Of me. I want to know the reason why.
You do not trust me.
No, I don't.
And trust is essential in human relationships. Oh, two Slovaks have given me this. It is full of strange hieroglyphics. Have a look at it. It might amuse you. And do not forget to write that letter, as I told you.
Good evening, Mr. Renfield.
Ah, yes. Doctor. Do come in. See what I have here.
Yes. That's a fine collection of flies.
When I have sufficient, I shall start collecting spiders.
To eat the flies.
Exactly.
But should you use so much of the food meant for you to attract insects?
I shall be compensated.
Well, I very much hope so.
Master, master, are you coming soon?
Open this door! Open this door! Open this door!
Lucy.
See if the evening post has arrived, I suppose.
I don't know what it is, but I have the most uneasy feeling about Jonathan. He said he'd write every day.
Afternoon, Miss Meadow. Miss Lucy.
Afternoon, Mr. Swales.
Still sitting among the tombstones. Do you know what lies was wrote on him? Look here. Sacred to the memory of George Cannon, falling off the cliffs of Whitby. Erected by his sorrowing mother to her dearly beloved son.
Really, Mr. Swales, I don't see anything funny in that.
Of course you don't. Because you don't know. You don't know his mother was Hellcat who hated him because he was hunchback. Young Cannon committed suicide rather than she get an insurance she put on his life. He stood on the edge of this cliff and he blew his brains out. So of course he fell over. Now there's a dangerous sight for you.
Dangerous?
The sky. There's a wind coming up. Them clouds. I've seen it all afore. There's a storm coming up over the horizon. I've seen it afore. I'd best get home and put up my shutters. My service, dear ladies.
On your own man. Scary in a way.
Oh, I don't think so, darling. Just eccentric. He needs to have an audience.
Perhaps he's right. Look at that cloud.
I've never seen such a storm. It's quite frightening. Wait. There. Oh, yes, I saw it. It's heading straight for the rocks. Oh, how terrible.
One of the puzzling aftermaths of last night's storm was the discovery in the early hours of the morning of the well-known figure of Skipper Swales.
What?
His body was lying on a gravestone underneath a bench.
A bench?
He'd been savaged by a dog.
Oh, no. Oh.
It is evident from the ship's logs. The crew are convinced themselves.
A strange man was haunting the ship. Some took to the boats, the remainder jumped overboard. It was then that the captain lashed himself to the helm. Isn't it exciting?
I think I'd call it tragic.
Oh, that of course. But exciting too.
And frightening.
Among the ship's cargo is a number of great wooden boxes filled with mould and consigned to a Whitby solicitor who took possession of them formally this morning.
Well, Whitby's such a quiet little place as a rule. The post! I think it's too bad of Jonathan not to write her a proper letter. I don't know what young people are coming to.
But, Mummy, there may be all sorts of reasons. And letters do go astray.
Particularly from abroad. Well, I can't help feeling there's something wrong.
It's three for Mummy.
Thank you, darling.
One for you, Lucy. I've got one for Mr. Hawkins.
It's from Quincy. He's coming down for the weekend.
Oh, good. That'll be nice of you, dear.
Mina? Just nothing, really. Mr. Hawkins has had a letter from Jonathan.
What does it say?
But he's on his way home and is waiting for the express at Bistritz.
Well, when does he leave?
June the 18th.
But he should have been home weeks ago. Lucy, whatever's wrong?
No, Lucy. Wake up.
What am I doing here?
You've been sleepwalking, darling. It's all right. I'm going to take you home. It's all right. Stand up. Stand before us, yes. Good girl. Right. Come on, Lucy. Let's go home now. Don't you think
no.
that...
No. No, no.
Please.
You know Mummy's ill. It would only worry her. Don't tell her.
Very well, dearest. I promise. Come on, let's get you to bed properly now. Take off your shawl. Oh, dear, how careless of me.
What is it?
Oh, when I fastened the brooch, I must have pricked you.
Oh, I didn't feel anything.
Why aren't you eating anything, darling?
Well, don't fuss, Mother.
You look so pale. Doesn't she look pale, Quincy?
Mm-hmm. She sure does.
Well, to tell you the truth, I do have rather a headache. It must be the excitement of seeing Quincy again.
Whoa there, little lady. I sure hope that ain't the effect I'll always have on you.
Why don't you go to bed, darling?
Yes, I think I will, if nobody minds.
That's a sensible girl. Good night, darling.
Good night, Mother.
Well, good night, sweetheart. I sure hope you feel better in the morning.
I'm sure I will. Tomorrow, we'll go sailing. And we'll have a lovely time.
Sure. Good night.
Oh, Quincy, I can't tell you how worried we've been. One day so happy and full of life. The next so white and... Oh, I don't know.
Well, isn't it time she saw a doctor?
Yes. I think we should go back to London at once. You wouldn't mind, darling, would you?
No, of course not.
And then Jack Seward could take a look at her.
That's just what I thought. Oh, well, Mina, it's such a lovely evening. Why don't you and Quincy stroll down to the promenade?
Well, I wonder if the American consulate in Budapest could help find out where Jonathan's gotten to.
Oh, Quinn, do you think they could?
Well, it's worth a try. See, they could start by making inquiries at Ivy Streets. Isn't that where you last heard from them?
Yes, it is. I would appreciate it. I'm so worried.
Well, I'll cable them just as soon as I get back to London.
Oh, thank you. Oh, shall we go back now?
Well, I guess it is turning a bit blowy. Let's go.
Yes.
There you are.
Yes. Yes, dearest.
I must have been dreaming.
Yes, darling. Tell me about it in the morning.
I shan't remember it in the morning. There was something tall with dark red eyes. And there was something sweet in the air. And yet very bitter. And then my soul seemed to go out of my body and float about the room. And then you came and tucked me up in bed. But I saw you do it before I felt it. Isn't that funny?
Did Quinn come into your dream?
Quinn?
Quincy, Lucy.
The man you're going to marry.
Quincy? Oh, no. I don't think it was Quincy.
Bowles?
Sir?
Any idea what the devil's going on over there?
Well, a car fight, sir.
Yes. They've been in that all afternoon.
They look bloody heavy, them boxes.
The devil's in them. I mean, I could understand if they were moving in furniture, but these things.
Didn't a foreign gentleman buy that old place, sir? The one that young Mr. Jonathan went abroad to see.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you, he was fascinated by the whole thing, sir.
Oh?
Renfield.
Really?
It's time for the afternoon round, sir.
Yes, of course.
Spiders, and every spider eats 50 flies, and each fly is a life. How many lives has that bird? 50 times 50.
Hello, Mr. Renfield. How's the experiment going?
Fly spiders, birds.
Yes,
spiders,
I
birds.
See. Yes. Tell me, how did you manage to catch them?
They were sent to me.
By whom?
I am not at liberty to disclose that.
Well, I see the spiders have managed to get rid of most of the flies.
Naturally. Dr. Seward.
Yes?
May I have a kitten?
Oh, come on, man. We can't have that. Now, come on, spit it out. Come on, spit it out.
Why? It is very wholesome. It is full of rich, strong life. It will give life to me.
Leave him, Bowles. Leave him.
Kitten, please. Dr. Seward, please.
Come and sit down. Sit down.
Well,
I don't think it's advisable, Mr. Renfield. Not just at the moment. Mr. Renfield, I'm going to give you an opiate. I hope you'll drink it.
Of course I will, Doctor. I know you are my friend. I will do whatever you tell me.
Thank you. Bowles will bring it along shortly.
Dinner time. My pretties.
Yes, Jonathan is safe.
Oh, and he's on his way home?
No, my dear. He's in Budapest. I've had a message from the American consulate there.
Yes, that was Quinn's doing, but couldn't Jonathan have written himself?
He's been quite ill, my dear. He's in hospital.
Hospital? What's been the matter?
Some terrible breakdown, it appears.
I must go to him.
I've already taken the liberty of making your travel arrangements. I'm having the tickets sent here by messenger. Now, God protect you, my dear. And a safe journey.
Oh, I must go and tell Mother straight away. Then I must pack. Yes, must pack. And I'd... Thank you, Mr. Hawkins. Thank you.
Thank you.
I hear that Mina's found her long-lost Jonathan. Bernard, nearly finished. Look up for me. Up at the ceiling. No hand. There. All over. Quite painless.
Is there anything really wrong with me, John?
Not so far as I can make out. There are none of the usual symptoms of anemia.
Will you tell Mother and Quincy that? They're so worried.
Yes, I certainly shall.
And thank you. Thank you for coming all this way.
My dear Lucy. Don't know how glad I always am to see you.
Good night, John.
I'm going to seek a second opinion.
That would why, Jack, we all have complete faith in you.
Well, thank you, Quincy, but there are certain illnesses which lie outside my province.
Who do you suggest?
I think I can persuade my old professor to come over from Amsterdam. Not only is he a good friend, he's also a brilliant diagnostician and a specialist in obscure diseases.
Good.
Goodbye, Mrs. Westman.
Goodbye, John.
Please, don't worry. Goodbye, Quincy.
Bye, Jack.
The post office, please, quickly. Lucy, may I present Professor Van Helsing?
May I say how honored I am at meeting a young miss who is loved by so many people.
Thank you.
And this is Mr. Homewood?
Ah, yes, the fortunate groom to be.
Professor?
It is love that makes the world go round. And like most
cliches.
It is true. One thing strikes me very forcibly. There are less smuts in London than when I was here last.
Oh, Professor, you make me feel better already.
You see? A terrible Dr. Seward. He says you're ghastly pale. How can you know anything of young ladies?
Oh, you mustn't be unkind about dear John.
No, you're quite right, Miss Westerner, for he is kind to give me shelter in his asylum. But you see, the young do not burden themselves to the young. But to me, who is old, I see many sorrows. The young ladies talk.
Lucy, I feel it is my duty to warn you against the blandishments of Professor Van Helsing.
Mrs. Westerner, may I plead with you to take these two young men downstairs, offer them a glass of sherry wine, perhaps?
Yes, of course. Come along, you two.
Young Miss Lucy and I want to have a friendly chat, do we not?
Yes, Professor.
Good. So, we pass over the facts that we know. No functional causes, no history of anemia, and so on and so forth. But, of course, there is a cause for everything. For instance, I notice you keep putting your hand to your throat. No? Why do you do that? And why do you wear that velvet band around it?
It's the fashion, Professor. And the buckle was given to me by Quincy.
He must be happy when you wear it.
Yes, he is.
But since he's not here at the moment, you may take it off.
Of course.
You should not hide so lovely a neck. Hmm.
Those marks were caused by my sister this summer at Whitby, when she pinned a shawl around me.
How long ago was that?
Just a few weeks ago.
Did it hurt?
No.
Has it hurt since?
No, it hasn't.
How did it come to pass that your sister was spinning a shawl around you?
It was chilly.
And?
I was walking in my sleep.
I see. Oh, well, that accounts for that. And when you sleep, do you have dreams?
Oh, yes. And at the time, they frighten me. But in the morning, I can't remember anything.
Do you think you could be worried about your forthcoming marriage?
Oh, no. I love Quincy very much.
Good. Now, one last thing. Will you allow me the liberty of examining your teeth and throat?
Of course.
Good. Now,
Good. Good. There. Finished. But I shall be back in a day or two, even if you're better, so that I can be charmed all over again. Au revoir.
Au revoir, Professor.
After a single examination, I do not wish to diagnose, but there is some memory stirring in my old brain. When we return to your asylum, John, we will telegraph Amsterdam for certain of my books. Then we shall solve the mystery.
We certainly shall.
In the meantime, let me know at once if there is any change.
Yes.
Transfusion of blood.
Oh, then I shall give it. I'd give the last drop of my blood for Lucy.
I do not ask as much of that, but yes, let us prepare cut-off sleeve rolled up. Now, little lady, here is your medicine.
See,
I lift you so that you may swallow easy. Come now, drink up like a good child.
Good evening. Master. What do you offer me?
More insects with steel and sapphire on their wings.
Yes, yes.
Moths. Skull and crossbones on the sides.
Oh, yes, yes.
Blood. Blood.
Yes.
Life. Years of life.
Yes, yes. Lord and Master, give me eternal life. Ooh. Ooh. Where's the doctor?
Well, he's not here tonight.
Get your straight waistcoat. Get the bandage, it's cut my wrist.
Blood is the life, the blood is the life. 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 I shall live forever. I shall live forever. I shall live forever. I shall live forever.
Yes, I agree. Using garlic seems like nonsense, but I sense something evil, and I must try everything to combat it. Evil will not disappear simply because we disapprove of it.
What is the evil?
I believe there is a monster in our midst. Who it is, or where it comes from, or what form it takes, I know not. But the one thing I am certain, we must find out. Even then, heaven knows if we are in time to stop it. Now, these are for you, Miss Lucy.
For me?
Yes, but they are not for you to play with. They are medicine.
Oh, do I have to eat them?
Oh, no, 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 no. Do not make a face. They are not for you to take any decoction. This pretty little necklace, for instance, is for you to wear around your neck. They help you to sleep. Like the lotus flower, it will make your troubles forgotten.
Ursa, you must be putting a joke on me. These flowers are nothing but common garlic.
I do not joke. There is purpose in all I do, and I must warn you, do not thwart me. Take care for the sake of others, if not for yourself.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my dear little Miss Lucy, please forgive me. There may be much virtue in so common a flower. Now, good job. Now we take some more. So, and we repeat the process around carefully the keyhole and all around, all the way around the door.
Jam.
Jam, really? Yeah. Well, very well, the jam of the door. Okay, so.
Is it?
Is it what, Miss Lucy?
Is it some sort of spell?
A spell, yes, perhaps. Perhaps it is no more than that. Oh, and take care not to disturb your pretty little necklace, eh? And even if the room is very close, do not on any account open the window or the door once you have finally retired for the night. You understand?
Promise.
Good. Have you finished, John?
I think so.
Good. Under here?
Oh, no. I don't think we should say anything to Lucy's mother about what we've been doing. It only make her more anxious.
I agree. To any questions, answer doctor's orders. So, tonight we can sleep in peace, and tomorrow young John and I will come to see if my spell has worked. Good night.
Good night, Lucy.
Don't leave me!
My dear, it'll be all right. We must trust the doctor.
Thank you.
poor girl. The struggle is proving too much for her.
Yes. I wish she hadn't insisted on going to the funeral. It upset her. What could have happened that made Mrs. Westman die of shock?
We should probably never know. John, look.
What?
The throat. What are those marks that have been there for nearly a month?
Good God, they're completely gone.
Overnight? She's dying. Go and fetch Quincy.
Yes. Yes, of course.
See the house again, sweetheart. It's going to be all ready to move into right after our honeymoon.
Oh, Quincy. Oh, Quincy, my love. I'm so glad you've come. Kiss me.
Not on your life!
What the hell, Quincy?
I swear it, my dear young miss. Come, Quincy. Take her by the hand. And kiss her on the forehead, but only once. Come, Quincy, look at her. Now look at her well.
She doesn't look sick anymore.
God is merciful.
She's at peace. It is the end.
Not so, alas. It is only the beginning.
You'd be surprised when we tell them that we're married.
Mm-hmm. We'll start to have something right away. Only me, promise me one thing.
What, my darling?
Promise me.
What?
Promise me that you will never, as long as we live, cook me paprika chicken.
A paprika hen? Oh, 9-9.
Oh, my good man, what do I owe you? Oh, my God! Look, look!
Is there the cab driving away?
No, no, he took no money. It's him. It's...
Jonathan, it's all right. Don't look anymore.
But you don't understand. It was Count Dracula.
Yes, darling. Let's go indoors.
I thought I had imagined it all.
There was just no way of letting you know how ill she'd become.
When was the funeral?
The day before yesterday.
Such terrible homecoming, my dear young people. You must believe we did everything we could. Dr. Seward and I have an assignation. We must take our leave. As you see.
And then?
Cut off her head.
What? Mutilate her body? Why?
It's
monstrous.
Friend John, I know you loved her, but there are certain things of which you have little knowledge. I do nothing without good cause.
The body's not there.
That is good logic as far as it goes. Now, I will tell you what I believe, and then we must speak with Quincy.
Body snatchers.
With the key to the vault? No. Try again, young friend. John, look. Good Lord. Well, now, what have we here?
A very blueful lady.
Blueful?
Do you mean beautiful, perhaps? Do you?
Yes.
Well, don't you think it is time that you were at home?
Yes.
Good. What have you got there? Oh, for me. Thank you. Good. Well, now, up you come, and off we go. My, what a handsome young man you are.
A very beautiful lady.
Yes? Oh. My God. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, no. Not so soon. First, I must ask you, are you willing to believe what John Seward and myself have told you?
I'm sorry, Professor. I reckon I find it impossible.
The wounds on the throat of that child, do they suggest nothing to you concerning the death of Miss Lucy?
Are you saying that those small holes in the child's throat were made in the same way as Lucy's?
Alas, no, I am not.
Well, what in Pete's name are you saying?
They were made by Miss Lucy.
You're insane.
She has already joined the ranks of the undead.
The undead?
The Nosferatu. The walking dead, those who cannot die, who are cursed with immortality, who must go on age after age, adding new victims, multiplying the evils of the world.
You see, Quincy, she became the prey of a vampire.
She is now a vampire herself. And now, I must tell you the terrible thing I propose to do.
Okay.
take this.
Hey, Professor.
Yes.
You're Lucy, my friend. No.
Leave these others, and we can rest together for eternity.
No! Answer me, friend Quincy. Am I to proceed with my work? When this undead lady becomes truly dead, then her soul shall again be free, and she shall take her place among the angels. So, John. Thank you. It will be a blessed hand that shall strike the blows.
Oh.
Brave young friend, a moment's courage, and it is done. So, place the point over the heart. So, take the stake in your left hand, take the hammer in your right hand, and when I begin to read the prayer for the dead, strike in God's name, so that the undead shall pass away. De profundis clamavi ad te, Domine, Domine exaudi voce meam. Fiantoris tui intendendis et tuas iniquitatis in nomine Christi. Omnium tuum dom. Fiat carnem meam in corpore. Serabit carnem meam in te. Ac ut erit fortuna et non cum spes. Requiem aeternam dona ego et lux perpetua lucet te. It is done.
Quincy, it's all over.
All right, Jack.
Good. Come, Quincy. Let me show you something. You see, no longer is she the devil's undead, but God's true dead, whose soul is with him. John, take Quincy back to the house. Give him a stiff brandy. Make him rest. I shall complete the exorcism, and we shall all meet tomorrow.
So there is no doubt in any of our minds that Mr. Jonathan's journal and Madam Mina's account of our summer days in Whitby prove that Count Dracula is a vampire and in this country.
No doubt at all.
Good. Your journey to Whitby, was it rewarding?
I think so. I spoke to the harbour master and a local solicitor. 50 boxes of earth were brought ashore from the wreck and delivered to Carfax.
I don't grasp the significance of these boxes or the earth.
It is only on earth that has once been consecrated, once been,
hallowed?
Exactly, thank you. Earth that has once been hallowed that the vampire can first seek sanctuary.
And where does this earth come from?
From the graves of Castle Dracula, from the Count's ancestors, from his children, his children's children, all hallowed grounds in the eyes of God. And we must stamp out this terrible and mysterious enemy. Do we fight? What say you?
I answer for Mina and myself.
Count me in, Professor.
I will do whatever I can, of course.
Little fly. By summer's play, my thoughtless hand hath brushed away. Am not I a fly like thee? Art not thou a man like me? For I dance and drink and sing till some blind hand shall brush my wing.
Mr. Renfield? Mr. Renfield, I'd like to introduce you to Mrs. Harker.
Good evening.
How do you do? You're the doctor, you're the lady. I myself am an instance of a man who once held a strange belief.
Indeed, Mr. Renfield. What was that?
I used to fancy that by consuming a multitude of living things, I could prolong life indefinitely. Isn't that so, Doctor?
That is so, Mr. Renfield. And you no longer hold that belief?
Oh, I have some advice on the subject of Madam Mina. Jonathan. Her help has been all important, but now she must have no more to do with this terrible affair. The risk is too great. She is too precious, and we men will act all the more free knowing that she is not in danger.
Very well. I'll take her back to Hampstead and then return here.
On this lock. It appears the Count has a penchant for stacking his boxes in holy places. Now, Jonathan, you know the layout of the house and grounds. Is there a chapel?
Yes, there is.
Good. Then lead us to it. On the stools, Domini. God in heaven.
Stench.
Where that monster clings to the place. Look.
Yes.
Come, quick. We will open the boxes one by one, and I will sterilize the earth.
How, Professor?
With this consecrated host. I have permission. With particles of the host, I shall sterilize the boxes, sanctify them, so that nevermore can he lie in them. Come, Quincy, open the bag. Let's get to work quickly.
God, look.
What is it?
Where? There in the corner.
Jonathan?
So young, so lovely.
So, after our visit last night to the Carfax house, at least we know that 29 boxes out of the 50 have been sanctified and rendered harmless. The Count can no longer find refuge there. But where are the 21 boxes that have been removed?
Sorry I'm late. Poor Mina's not feeling very well. I told her to stay in bed for a while. Now, John, Mina's very anxious to speak with your patient Renfield again. She thinks there might be some kind of a link between him and the Count, that he may talk to her openly.
What do you think, Professor?
I don't know. I don't know. It might work. It might help.
Oh, thank you. Well, she felt the evening might be the most rewarding time.
Very well, I'll arrange it.
Oh, good.
Say, listen, everybody. Got in touch with Carter Patterson. Now, they tell me they picked up those 21 boxes from Carfax and delivered them to an address in Mayfair. That's 21A Chesterfield Close.
Mayfair. Well done, young Quincy. Well done. That should be our next port of call. And now, how about a nice cup of cocoa?
Thank you, Professor.
Young lady to see you, Mr. Renfield. I'll be nearby when you're ready to leave, miss. If you take my meaning.
Thank you. Good evening, Mr. Renfield.
Who are you?
I'm Mrs. Harker. We spoke yesterday.
Where?
In the garden. I was with Dr. Seward. I was very interested in what you were saying about eternal life.
You look different today.
Do I?
Quite different.
Tell me then more about your theories, flies and spiders and so on.
The wings of a fly are typical of the aerial powers of the psychic faculties.
Yes, I can see the analogy.
The ancients did well to typify the soul as a butterfly.
Are you interested in souls, Mr. Renfield?
Of course I'm not. Life is all I want.
Doesn't each life possess a soul?
What?
Even a fly and the sparrow. Can one take a life without being responsible for the soul?
Why do you go on about souls? I don't want to know about souls.
I had a terrible dream last night.
You're trying to confuse me.
Mr. Renfield, will you help me?
Why?
I feel we understand each other. In this dream I had, dogs were barking on the heath. I thought I heard you shouting, protesting. Couldn't understand what you were saying. I dreamt that my life was being slowly drained away, and that when I had no more blood, my soul would never find peace.
Your soul?
Yes. What do you think, Mr. Renfield? That in some way I could have been so sinful that I must spend my afterlife in purgatory?
Pray God I may never see your sweet face again. May he bless you and keep you. My God.
Goodbye, Mr. Renfield.
Want to see Will?
Thank you, Bobby.
Dr. Seward. Dr. Seward. You must let me go at once from here.
Go, Mr. Renfield. But why?
Now, this very hour. Let them take me in a straight waistcoat. Manacles, leg iron, even to prison. Let me go.
Is it something Mrs. Harker said was upset?
If I were free, I shouldn't hesitate a moment to tell you, but I'm not my own master. So let me go, 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 let me go.
I'm afraid we shall have to wait until the morning to discuss it.
I'm not a lunatic in a mad fit. I'm a sane man, fighting for his freedom.
Come, Mr. Renfield. No more of this. Come, I want you to go to your room. Try to behave more discreetly.
Dr. Seward, I trust you will do me the honor to remember that when this night is out, I did what I could to convince you.
I could have been so sinful that I must spend my afterlife in purgatory.
Why did you refuse what I have sent you?
I do not want you here.
Why?
If thought is life and strength and breath, and the want of thought is death, then am I a happy fly, if I live or if I die.
You should be overjoyed by what I have sent you.
You've sent me nothing.
Look at me. Look at me.
Look at me.
I have sent you a human being, a living person. She's initiated. Take from her and give to her. two of you will live forever.
God give me strength.
He has previously shown the same growing excitement as, for example, when he asked for a kitten. This excitement...
I would not send her soul to purgatory.
Who? Whose?
He has started. Mrs. Harker.
Oh, my God, Mina.
Go to her. Go to her. Go to her. Oh, my God. Take my soul to your bosom.
Bowles, get my carriage. Yes. Quickly. Mr. Damsted.
Please, do not help these men to fight against me. They're superstitious fools. They've been losing for 2,000 years. Do you know the significance of the kiss? You are nourishment to me. Blood of my blood. Flesh of my flesh. My beautiful wine press. We shall cross land and sea together. Land and sea. Take from me. Take. Drink. 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 Life. Life. Drink. 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 Drink.
Been here.
Why didn't you wake me?
I tried.
Mina, that blood.
Yes. No, don't touch me. I mustn't touch you. I mustn't kiss you.
Madam Mina. Have no fear. God will protect you. And we shall now invoke his help by touching your forehead with the Holy Eucharist.
In nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus, Sancti.
Unclean! Even the Almighty shuns me.
Books tell me that he was an extraordinary man. Soldier, cunning statesman. No branch of study was too difficult for him. And the power of his brain has survived his death. In nomine Patri, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. But he shall not escape. We shall corner him. And we shall drive the stake through his heart.
I pray God that I may do the deed.
God will act in his own way and in his own time. Mesa Thomas.
Yes, yes, it always sounds more convincing in Latin, Professor, doesn't it? You give an order to retreat.
We guard ourselves from your touch.
Using a cross as a talisman, an instrument of torture and humiliation.
A symbol of trouble and trial by which our Christian faith is tested.
You seek to destroy me. Why?
Because of what you are and what you've done.
We must survive, all of us. The blood of a human for me, a cooked bird for you. What is the difference?
The difference between good and evil.
I am bound to this earth. I make it my domain. You will die in a miserable allotted span. I have centuries before me.
Why, in God's name, did you ever leave your castle?
We must recruit disciples, just as your leader has done.
You shall not capture any more souls.
Souls? There is no blood to drink from souls, if there be such things.
We are pledged to rid the world of you.
It will not be easy. I do not die like the bee when I sting once. I become stronger. Vampires are nourishment to one another. Beautiful, fundamental nourishment. And your wife, Mr. Harker, is mine. Already.
You think you will leave me with no place to rest?
I know that you must fight, but it must not be a fight of hate. That poor soul who's brought about all this misery is the saddest one of all.
Mina, how can you say such things? If I could send his soul to burning hell forever, I would do it.
Hush, Jonathan. You must be pitiful to him, just as someday you may have to be pitiful to me. Also, I believe the Count can somehow force me to tell him what I know and be in league against you.
I don't believe that.
No? Do you think that I don't look at myself in the mirror?
Oh, dearest, don't.
Yes, yes, we must face facts, however unpleasant. Tell me, how many boxes did you find at Barnsley?
8.
And at the Mile End?
4.
And sanctify them all?
Yes.
1 box left. Madam Mina, you are the wisest of us all. So tell us, where do you think the last box is?
There's only one place he'd feel really safe.
cannot be far from my destination.
We will take the shortcut. Come on.
Madam Mina?
Yes, sir, Professor.
How do you know this is the shortcut to Castle Dracula?
From Jonathan's account of his journey, of course.
Ah, yes. Yes, of course.
Your meal is ready here, Professor.
How charming.
Thank you. Oh.
And yours, my dear little chef?
No. I have to confess, I was so hungry, I've already eaten.
Oh. Excuse me. Perfect. It's almost dawn. Come to the fire, Madam Mina, and get warm. For you, I fear.
For me? None safer from them than me. I, too, am their sister.
Come with us.
thank you. There's a son.
Yes. Thanks be to God. Now you can safely sleep, Madam Mina. Until the sun sinks again.
Where are you going, Herr Professor?
I have work to do at the castle. Has come, Madam Mina. Are you afraid?
No, of course not. I'm in your hands.
We are both of us in God's hands. Thank you. Oh, Madam Mina, well done. One more flicker and it will be gone.
Sunset. Dust to dust, ashes to ashes.
Look, there's no more mark.
Jonathan, is it really true?
It is true. You have nothing more to fear. Thank you, God, for protecting us and for all your mercies and for choosing us to be your instruments for good. Amen.
Amen. Amen.